folks, how we dealing? Holy mother trucker, it's hot. Look at it. It's like the morning, so it's only about 7:30. And yet the heat. Ain't that good, you know? I reckon it's about 50 now. 60? 70? I don't friggin' know. I think it's like 22. That's enough. Well, I even got my X Factor on. Oh, not X Factor. Me Factor 80. I got some Factor 80 suntan on because you don't want to get burnt. We all want a nice tan, don't we? But we don't want the pain that goes with it. I'm a bit like that. I don't want the frigging pain. I just want the nice brown tan. But the problem is, I don't know if you can see, like hot from about there, well, from about a quarter of the way down my arm, it's quite brown. But that's a gradual thing. That's because I wear t-shirts. And over the last few months, it's not been stupid hot, it's just been warm. So my arms have gone a bit brown. Because I've got a t-shirt on, as you can see, I've got like t-shirt sleeve upwards is pale. So I'm trying to whack them out in the next couple of days to get a tan. But I'll put some Factor 50 on and then I top that up with Factor 30. I thought, yeah, you got Factor 80 on now, mate. Now frickin' sun's getting your bloody arms. I thought, well, that's the whole point. I wanted to. But I woke up this morning, 5 a.m. on the dot. It's like, what the hell are you waking up for now? It's friggin' early, man. You got another, at least another 24 minutes. Check the weather for the day. 30 degrees. Whoop-de-doo-dahs. Call your mother. You're not coming home tonight. It's going to be a hot one. Yeah, 30 degrees. Then I've scrolled through the weather to 6 p.m. tonight where I'm at. Thunderstorms. We're going to have thunderstorms like 2 hours then back to 30 degree heat till Friday. But then I fell back to sleep for like an hour and I started dreaming about thunderstorms. It's as though the just reading that we're going to have a thunderstorm today and a bit of relief from this heat made me have like wet dreams about thunderstorms. I had a dream that I was dead excited. I was with a lot of people. I don't know who the hell they were. Somebody called Pete and that makes sense, doesn't it, Dirty Pete? Yeah, there's a few of us there anyway. And I had gone out with some lasses for a drink. And I was like, Aim, you got to get back. There's going to be a thunderstorm. It's going to be amazing. And yeah, so I got dead excited about the thunder. And then I woke up, I was like, was it a dream all along? Are we actually going to have thunderstorms today? And I checked in, we am. I was like, yes, man. Cool me down, baby. What else is going on? I've messed up my back. I've effed it up big time. My lower back on the left-hand side. I don't know how. I think it's called getting old. It's just one of them things like you wake up, bad back, that sort of thing. There's a pigeon here. Let's have a look. Hello, Mr. Pigeon. Oh, he can fly at least. I was worried he couldn't fly then. What I would have done to help him, I don't bloody know. Couldn't exactly put him in my back pocket, could I? Well, yeah, we tried to save a pigeon once, you know. When we used to live in an old house that we used to live in years ago. There's a pigeon injured in the garden. So I went and got it. But we had like this huge cage. Because we used to have some degus. Degus are kind of like squirrels, but rats at the same time. And these degus had passed away and whatnot. Got about a year old and we still had the cage. So I put some straw in or whatever for the pigeon, some food. And I put the pigeon in there. It's quite docile and not really doing much. I thought we'll get to the vet the next day. I think it was a Sunday when we got it. Come down Monday morning, but it strangled itself, stuck its head through the bars and just choked out. It's like, that's nasty. Poor thing. I had to squeeze its head back through. It's horrible. Yeah, anyways. Bad back. Messed it up, don't know how. I just got up and bad back. Hey. It was one of them pains where literally every step you take, it feels like you want to punch a penguin in the face. I don't know why I picked penguins, so they always look dead happy. And because I'm in so much pain, I'd just have to punch one right now. But that is not true. I'm not against animals. I'm all against animal cruelty because penguins, believe it or not, are my favourite animal. Or are they a mammal? I don't know, but they're my favourite, whatever they are. I absolutely love penguins. I've got like a stuffed penguin at home that I bought me a couple of years ago. Because she knows how much I love penguins. When we go to the zoo, I just stand there watching penguins for ages. So cool. But if you asked me to pick one up, I'd probably crap myself. Anyways. If she has to pick one up, I'd probably crap myself. Oh well. Anyways, what's happening today, I hear you ask? Well, apart from thunderstorm.com, not a great deal. Just a bit of this and a bit of that and a bit of your other. Oh, shit. Sorry. We're getting ready. Well, I say we're getting ready. I'm getting ready to go away to my mother's on Friday. We're back up north. Homeward bound for a few days. Going to see the family. Going up to see my granddad. It's an odd one because for all I know, I mean, every time I see any of my family, it could be the last time I ever see him, just because you don't know what the hell's around the corner, do you, really? And I live 100 odd miles away. But with my granddad being 80 odd and not in the best of health at all, I guess I have oxygen on all the time, even at home. Yeah, he's just deteriorating all the time. So, for all I know, this could be the last time I get to see my granddad. I didn't really get that chance with my gran, because saw my gran, and then a few months later, I got a phone call. Your gran's been rushed to hospital. By the time I got there, she was already in not a coma, but she was unconscious or whatever. She was just on oxygen or something or other, and the next day she passed away. Didn't really get a chance to spend a day with my gran, so I wanted to do it with my granddad. So I'm doing that on Friday, seeing my dad and his missus, my stepmother, Geordie. Oh, Geordie. I know you're not watching, but hello anyways. Hello to all Geordies out there, including the one that's my stepmum. Right there, let's switch hands. So doing that Friday. Saturday, I don't know. Might go out Saturday night for some drinks. Or might do a live with my mother, which we've done before, and that was entertaining. We got a piss of the fart on the live, to the point where it was just hilarious to watch. So I might do that. We'll see what the weekend brings. Sunday, easy day. Me and Aim probably go down the beach if the weather's good. Get some fresh air. So that's the plans, guys, for the weekend. What else was going on? I can't remember, there was so much to tell you. Oh yeah. So as a lot of you know, we are looking to move. That is still the case. We found a beautiful bungalow yesterday. We need a bungalow, realistically, because of Bren. You know, Bren can't walk around as easily as she could in the past. She uses a walker and a wheelchair. So, we're after a bungalow, ideally. Or a house with two decent reception rooms, so she could have a bedroom stroke living room downstairs, like she has now. And this bungalow, beautiful. Three bedrooms. A big extension, huge garden, two reception rooms. I thought, this is amazing. It was only like slightly more than what we pay now. I mean, it's up near my mum and dad, which is where we want to move to. Tried to get a viewing, emailed the letting agent. It only went on yesterday morning, bear in mind. It hadn't even been released to like the main estate agents. We sort of get notifications saying, oh, look, this property's becoming available. Do you want to have a look? And they sort of let us know early on, along with other people who also signed up for the notifications. Anyway, it's like, yeah, let's go for it, baby. Email them, don't hear back from them. Check later on, it's been took down, it's already been gone. So if anyone has a bungalow, stroke cottage, stroke mansion in the Lancashire area, i.e. Lancaster or Morecambe, look at that sun, man, look at the sun, then get in touch. I will pay you each month with a free mukbang. Nah, I'm joking. But yeah, hopefully that comes off sooner rather than later, because we wanted a summer up there. We honestly wanted to be up there by now. So Tia could be starting college or work. We could be having a summer up there and getting it into the, getting into the vibe of the new job that my dad has ready for me when I get up there. Aim was hoping to get herself a little part-time job, like work it around looking after her mum. She was even offered it when we was last up there. If you watch our vlog from Wednesday Morecambe last time, she was offered a job. Literally just this lady came out and said, do you want a job? Because she got to talk to this lady in this really nice bistro stroke calf. It was like, would have suited her down to the ground, part-time hours. And I said, hey, let's just move up here now. Let's not go home. Let's just stay up here. I'll start the job that my dad has for me. You start this job. We'll start making a bit of money. Tia and your mum stay down here for a month or so. Once we get a property, just move them up. But no, didn't happen, and rightly so, because That was just my head's talking. I was like, just take the chance, Lee. Just move now whilst you got the chance. I knew it was a stupid idea. Even as I was saying it, it was sounded stupid. So it didn't happen. But hopefully we do get ourselves a house, cottage, mansion, castle, whatever soon. Bungalow, cardboard box, whatever. Anyways, see y'all in a bit.